The invention of the modern computer can be traced back to a chance encounter at a train station one evening in the summer of 1944. On the platform of Aberdeen Station in Maryland, mathematician Hermann Goldstein bumped into John von Neumann, arguably the most famous scientist in America at the time after Einstein. Von Neumann was a child prodigy who was born in Budapest, Hungary. At the age of six, he could divide eight-digit numbers in his head and was known to recite entire books from memory after a single read. He laid the foundations of set theory and provided a rigorous framework for quantum mechanics. Goldstein recognized von Neumann immediately on that train platform and introduced himself. Goldstein was working at a weapons testing facility in Maryland, calculating artillery firing tables to determine how far shells would fly under various conditions. He mentioned to von Neumann that he was collaborating with a team at the Moore School of Electrical Engineering at the University of Pennsylvania who were building an electronic computer capable of performing 300 multiplications per second, the ENIAC. Upon hearing about the ENIAC, von Neumann's demeanor totally changed.
Von Neumann had this reputation for kind of being quite jocular, enjoying a drink, telling dirty jokes and stuff like that. But immediately he could be extremely serious and his mathematical mind would just switch on.
Von Neumann became instantly focused. Despite being deeply involved in the Manhattan Project, where he was responsible for finding computing resources for bomb calculations, he had never heard of the ENIAC, this revolutionary new machine. Up until then, scientists at Los Alamos had been relying on punched card machines and mechanical calculators to complete complex calculations on shockwaves and blast effects. The ENIAC, designed by former physics teacher John Mauchly and electronics whiz kid J. Presper Eckert, was 30 feet by 50 feet, roughly the size of a large classroom. It contained over 17,000 vacuum tubes and, when powered up, caused lights in the surrounding neighborhood to flicker. Goldstein invited von Neumann to see the monster of a machine in person.
And immediately von Neumann gets sucked in. He just knew from day one how important computers would be.
I spoke with Anano Bhattacharya, the author of a biography on von Neumann called The Man from the Future.
And after the war, he met up with an acquaintance, and very famously this acquaintance says to him, "I hear all you're thinking about these days is bombs." And von Neumann says, no, that's not right, that's not correct. I'm thinking about something that's far more important than bombs. I'm thinking about computers.
Von Neumann immediately recognized the usefulness of computers beyond the war effort, but also quickly identified the limitations of the ENIAC. Most notably, the ENIAC couldn't be reprogrammed easily, as it lacked the ability to store instructions in memory. If you wanted to change the machine's operation, for example, switching from multiplication to division, technicians had to manually rewire its labyrinth of crisscrossed wires, adjusting 6,000 switches and cables, a cumbersome process that could take days or even weeks to complete. Von Neumann saw an opportunity to improve the machine by proposing a groundbreaking new design. A computer with a stored program architecture, called the EDVAC. Instructions and data would be stored in memory, allowing the machine to be reprogrammed without manual rewiring. In 1945, von Neumann's first draft of a report on the EDVAC was released, describing for the first time the structure of a stored program computer. He called for it to have a memory capacity of 8,000 words, each 32 bits long. And most importantly, this allowed the computer to execute instructions directly from memory without needing manual intervention. The design wasn't perfect, though. Both instructions and data had to travel in turn along the same path between the memory and the CPU. This slows down the computer, as the CPU often has to wait for each instruction or piece of data to be fetched before moving on to the next task. Despite the bottleneck, von Neumann effectively produced the blueprint that gave birth to the modern computer.
That blueprint was so clear, was so logical, he made it seem obvious to everybody that this is how we should go forward and develop all computers from here on in.
Ironically, it wasn't even von Neumann who circulated his draft report to dozens of scientists and engineers worldwide. It was Goldstein. ENIAC's designers Eckert and Mauchly were furious. Horrified, even. They had hoped to patent their designs for the ENIAC and future computers like the EDVAC, aiming to make millions. But since von Neumann's report was widely distributed, everything was now in the public domain and could no longer be patented. Mauchly protested, insisting, Johnny did not alter the fundamental concepts which we had already formulated for the EDVAC. Although Eckert and Mockley believed the EDVAC was a natural evolution from the ENIAC, historians argue that it was von Neumann who crystallized the idea of a programmable computer.
So it took von Neumann to set this down clearly.
Von Neumann later testified that the purpose of the EDVAC report was to further the art of building high-speed computers. My personal opinion was at all times, and is now, that this was perfectly proper and in the best interests of the United States. After the war, von Neumann pursued his vision of building a computer at the Institute for Advanced Study in Princeton, where he was the youngest faculty member. His decision to build a computer stunned and horrified some of his colleagues who were used to working with pencil and paper. Despite significant pushback, von Neumann pushed ahead, arguing that computers would open new worlds for mathematicians and scientists, much like the 200-inch telescope allowed astronomers to observe previously unseen galaxies and expand our understanding of the universe. His IAS machine was a model for many early computers, including IBM's first commercial computer, the IBM 701, introduced in 1952. Physicist Edward Teller would later say, "Probably the IBM company owes half its money to Johnny von Neumann." Behind the scenes, von Neumann's second wife, Clara Dan, played a critical role in the transition that helped transform the ENIAC into an EDVAC-style computer. Though she described herself as a mathematical moron, she wrote an 800 command program on the ENIAC, simulating the paths of neurons inside an atomic bomb.
There's no doubt at all that Clara's code was the first truly useful modern computer program ever to have been executed.
While Alan Turing is often celebrated as a computer pioneer, it was von Neumann who turned these abstract ideas into a blueprint for building real machines. Today, nearly all computers, from smartphones to supercomputers, are built on von Neumann architecture. His open sharing of ideas culminated in a long legal battle that was finally resolved decades after his death. When a judge ruled in 1973 that the automatic electronic digital computer was part of the public domain and could not be patented, it rendered one of the most valuable and transformative inventions in the history of humankind unpatentable. If you're inspired by how von Neumann brought computers to life, you can dive into programming yourself with Brilliant's Applied Python course, where you can begin building real-world applications right away, thanks to Brilliant's drag-and-drop editor. What sets Brilliant apart is its totally interactive and hands-on approach. You're not just watching videos, you're actively solving problems as you go. I've been spending just 10 minutes a day with Brilliant's new data science content, which uses real-world data to train you to see trends and make better decisions. For example, you'll analyze Airbnb data to find the best neighborhoods to invest in rental properties. Whether you're into math, programming, AI, or anything STEM-related, Brilliant has something for everyone from beginners to those looking to sharpen their skills. And it's free for you to try out. Just sign up with my link, brilliant.org/newsthink. That's brilliant.org/newsthink for a free 30-day trial, link in the description, or scan the QR code on your screen. By using my link or code, you'll also get 20% off Brilliant's annual premium subscription, unlocking thousands of lessons to fuel your learning. Thanks for watching. For Newsthink, I'm Cindy Pom.